Hello, hello, hello. Today is Monday, June 10, 2024. Here follow the solutions, the answers to problem 203. About the moons of Saturn. It was a very, very easy problem. Many correct solutions, and I therefore decided not to mention all of you, not all 15. As you probably know, Eugen and Keith Norman always sent me by email their solutions. I show you here the summary of Eugen's solutions. I will keep it on for a minute or so that you can check his numbers. And if you're then ready for Keith Norman's solutions, you will see also his video solution. Okay, so you're now ready for Keith Solutions. There we go.
This is Keith's solution to Walter Lewin's problem 203, and it concerns the moons of Saturn. We're given a table of information about the distances of the various moons from Saturn, the period of the orbits, and we need to find, fill in the blanks basically, we need to find the periods of four of the moons and the orbital speeds of all of them. And we're also asked to find the mass of Saturn. So I've chosen M, mass M for Saturn. M1 here is going to be Tethys, the closest moon into Saturn. Mass M1, period T1, and then any other moon, any of the other four, I've set as M2 and period T2. We can learn all about this in his Walter Lewin's lecture 14 of 801. And also, don't forget there are lots of modules, and in this case, 801X module 10.01 is 10 minutes or so, which is also relevant to this. These tend to get overlooked a bit. We're all looking at his lectures, hopefully we are, but there's some really good stuff in these, and as I say, they're only sort of 5, 10, 15 minutes long, so don't forget those. Use the search facility on his homepage, and you can find these. Okay, so if I consider the first moon, Tethys, for M1, I must balance the gravitational force between M and M1 with the required centripetal force to establish stable circular motion. And that gives me that equation there. Strictly that's a vector equation, but we know that in all the cases the forces are going to be acting radially for each M to M. Okay, so that's the equation for M1, gravitational force balances centripetal force required for circular orbit. Similarly for M2, I get this equation, and this is going to be for any of the other moons. So a bit of a rearranging and elimination, I get from my first equation that, and from the second equation that. I can then form a ratio that relates the two radii of the orbits to the two speeds of the two orbital speeds. Okay. Right, from the previous page we had that equation, the ratio of speeds to orbital diameter, orbital radii. Okay, but I also know that the orbital speed, just take the magnitude, is simply 2 pi times the radius, the circumference, divided by the period for each situation, M1 and M2. Hence, I can now form this equation, which relates the orbital speeds to the periods and the radii. Okay, I put that into this equation here and get that, and I now produce a relationship between the periods of M1 and M2 related only to the radii of M1 and M2. So for Dione, or Dione, I think it's probably Dione, I can simply feed in the values that we've got from our table. That's in days, that's in units of 10 to the 5 kilometers, and that's in units of 10 to the 5 kilometers. So not SI units, but it's a ratio, so it all cancels out. And I get for DNA 2.73 days. I can then repeat the same process, just feeding in the different radii for the orbits for the other three moons. So that's part of the problem done. For the orbital speed, I go back to one of the equations I had on the previous page, this one here, and I know all the information for Tethys, so I can simply feed it in, but this time I need to be aware that I have to convert to meters and seconds, which is what I do here. And I then get to three significant figures, three digits of precision, 11.4 kilometers per second. Okay, from the equation we had previously, this one, I can form a relationship between V2 and V1, speed 2, speed 1, again relating to the radii. So I can then work through all the other moons having found this one. And that's what I do here. So for Dione, I get 10.0 kilometers a second to three significant figures. And similarly for the others, I get that. Finally, I go back to the first equation I had, where we were balancing gravitational force against centripetal force required for circular motion. Simplifying and eliminating, I can get this equation here, and I've got all the information I need, including the gravitational constant, and I simply work it out. And to three significant figures, I get 5.69 times 10 to the 26 kilograms. And that is my solution to problem 203. Thank you.